The main challenge in creating this shape is this transition here. This is further complicated by this inner conical face. At first, I tried to do this by using just simple extrudes, but I could not get a close enough shape. I then proceeded to use a surface patchwork approach, building each of these faces one by one. I'll be showing that workflow here. I'm going to start by building this inner face. We shall begin with this conical surface body. Let's trim this with a sketch that was created on the right plane. Go to Modify, Trim. Select the sketch as the trim tool. Select this portion of the surface to remove. We need to trim this further using this straight line sketch. Let's turn our attention to the face on the outside. I prepared a base sketch on the top plane. I've also created another sketch on a higher plane. This sketch is just a simple offset of the base sketch. Go to Create, Loft. Check on the Chain Selection option. Select the base sketch as the first profile. Select the higher sketch as the second profile. We need to trim this loft to shape using this sketch created on the front plane. The model is coming into shape now. We will be lofting from the edges of the inner face to the edges of the outer face. To have a better transition, we need to round off these corners. This face is not entirely flat, so we will not be able to create a sketch. Let's take a look at the following method. Go to Modify, Extend. Remove the Tangent Chain option so that we can select edges individually. Select these two edges. Set Type to Perpendicular. Adjust the distance. The value does not matter here. With this edge, we can now create a fillet. Next, Select these faces and delete. Repeat the same steps for the other side. We have now rounded off the corners. Go to Create, Loft. Turn on the Chain Selection option. Select the inner profile, followed by the outer profile. Try your best to adjust the loft handle such that the line is parallel to the front plane. Right now, these two edges lie along the same plane. We need to create a base with a certain thickness. So I am going to adjust this face slightly downwards. Go to Modify, Extend. For Type, set to Natural. Select this edge and adjust the distance. Now, we need to patch up these two openings. Go to Create, Patch. Turn on the Enable Chaining option. Select these two open loops. Now we have a watertight surface body. Go to Modify, Stitch. Select all the surface bodies and stitch them into a single solid body. From here, we can slightly trim off the top and add in fillets.